Dear friends, recently when the former Attorney General Tommy Thompson released his memoir, it sent shockwaves, especially among the political elites of our country. Because many things that have happened in Malaysia, many of us are wondering, what is the truth? These days, especially in the world, there's a lot of cover-up, there's a lot of lies and fake news. Sometimes we wonder what is really true. Now, when someone speaks out something, if we want to know whether there's some truth to what he's saying, we have to always ask, what is motivating that person? Is he motivated by some self-interest, but he wants to gain some popularity or fame? Or here in releasing this book, maybe he wants to get a lot of people to buy the book. He will become rich through the sales of this book. What could have been motivating the former Attorney General? Well, all we know about him is that he has always been a very truthful, honest, a man of integrity, a man of courage. And I would say most probably his motivation was to expose what has been really happening in Malaysia. And so I would rather listen to him than listen to all the comments or the backlash that's come out because of this book. Yes, brothers and sisters in Christ, when truth is spoken, there is always a reaction. There is often a backlash. And we see this in today's gospel. John the Baptist, when he spoke the truth, when he had confronted Herod and his wife Herodias, that they were living a sinful, adulterous life. He was thrown into prison. And here in this story, we see the sad account of how John the Baptist was beheaded through the insidious actions of Herod's wife Herodias in getting Herod to chop off his head. Today we also celebrate the feast of Saint Agatha. Saint Agatha is a martyr in the church. She lived around the 3rd century and she was tortured and killed. Why? Because she made a vow of virginity. She had consecrated her life to live as a virgin for Jesus. But here there was this high-ranking person in society who desired her, who wanted her for himself. But when she refused, he did all kinds of things. Got her, put into prison, put in a prison, even in a brothel. Got her tortured. Her breast was pulled out. She was stripped naked and rolled on fiery coal. Yet to all this, Saint Agatha remained faithful because she said that her life belonged to Jesus. Brothers and sisters in Christ, today's word encourages us not to be afraid of speaking the truth. Yes, we will get a backlash. We may get strong reactions from others. But God's word also tells us that the truth will set us free. In our marriages, when there is truth, it will heal conflict. And this week, as we also remember the International Week of Harmony. Yes, we need religious harmony. We need harmony between people. There's so much of division in the world today. Yes, harmony is got by having solidarity in diversity, that means we respect the differences of others. Harmony does not mean uniformity where everything is the same. If there is to be true harmony among religions and different people, it has to be founded on truth. It has to be founded on respect, justice, and fraternal love for each other. Let us practice these beautiful virtues. Let us not be afraid to stand for the truth and live honest and authentic lives in our relationship, be it in our family or with others. Let us dare to speak the truth and live the truth, and to this build a much more harmonious society in the world today. God bless.